Sindhu, when we watch you and we sort of celebrate you, interview you, what we actually see is you Rio, you World Championship. What we don't see is 4:30 a.m. Hyderabad with Gopi. What we don't see is 5:30 every day, 2 hours of commute. Can you tell my audience that particular story after the Australian Open, you coming back, Gopi alone, giving you that paper and saying 1, 2, 3 things not with you. I won't say the 1, 2, 3, you tell my audience.
So before Olympics, I think before 2.5-3 months, there was an Australian Open where I lost in the pre-quarterfinals. And after that, he said, okay, fine, enjoy it here. And after going back, I think it's going to be really tough because we have to prepare for the Olympics. And it was all fine then. And then we went back to India. And he said, you know, just write your mistakes in a paper and even I'll write and just come to the office and just show it. So I've just written some points that where I'm lacking behind in my mistakes. And he wrote those 3-4 points, which I can say actually made a difference.
But, say them, say them.
Yeah, I mean, I came to the office and I told my mistakes and he was like, okay, and this is what you have to do. From my side, is one was, you know, we have to practice really hard and we have to be focused all the time. And second one is, you know, the diet, no sugar, basically. And third one is no phone. And there were some of mistakes from my side. But yeah, as soon as he said that, I was like, okay, fine. At that point of time, I was like, okay. But now I actually think, how did I do it?
Sindhu says, going back home that evening, she realized for a 21-year-old, she was told no phone for the next 8 months. No WhatsApp, no internet, nothing, without a mobile phone. That's what you made her do. How can you do that, Gopi? And most importantly, will you do that again leading to Tokyo?
Well, the fact is that special tournaments need special preparations. It's not that I've done it with Sindhu in 2016. It was also the case with Saina in 2012. Because some things which you're used to and you have it all the time, sometimes when you drop that thing, it almost is reminding you of the fact that you have dropped it for a reason. And it's not the phone actually, but the fact is that you're continuously reminded that I don't have a phone because I'm preparing for the Olympics. You're not eating the foods which you like because you're preparing for the Olympics. So the focus completely revolves around that. So we had this conversation. I made a sign on that paper saying that I'll abide by it. And then I took a phone away. But I believe it was important. And she tries not to accept the fact that that was the most important thing because she's scared that I might do it again. But I'm sure whatever it takes for good preparation, we'll do it when it's needed.